Może być coś, bo są tak kolega, po prostu sobie musiał się przeżywać. To jest to. Prosta figura akrobatyczna. Symbol akrobatic figure. Ok. Love, horse, and what we can find. I don't know, maybe somebody help me. Kto może pomyśleć coś jeszcze? No? What? Kalia, can I give you a suggestion? Yes, of course.
A fish.
A fish?
What do you think about a fish?
Could you show me this? How it looks fishy? Okay, a fish. We can make fish. Right, together, please make a fish. Okay, this is fish. Okay, thank you very much, guys. This is fish. Could you repeat? Spróbujcie, słuchajcie, żebyśmy przećwiczyli te wszystkie trzy figury, czyli mamy Olaf, horse and fish. Perfect.
Welcome from the Centennial Hall on day 7 of the World Games 2017 from Wrocław in Poland, and the final day of gymnastics. We are about to begin a session of finals action in acrobatic and trampoline gymnastics. First, it will be the women's double mini trampoline final, then the acrobatic men's group final. That will be followed by the men's tumbling final before we finish with the women's synchro trampoline. You can see lots of the gymnasts that have already taken part in competition here in the World Games watching on. It's 4 medal events to be decided here today at the Centennial Hall, and it'll take us to 20 gymnastics events as a whole. Across the entire program, the Russian Federation have taken 9 out of 16 golds. China have 3. Spain, Japan, Germany and the Republic of Korea have each won 1 gold. But do expect some variety today. Qualification has been fascinating for these 4 events. In yesterday's finals, it was Mikhail Zalamin of the Russian Federation who won the men's double mini trampoline, and Yafang Fang of the People's Republic of China who took gold in the women's tumbling. Acrobatic gymnastics, the Russian Federation were also the gold medalists in the women's group final, and Tim Sebastian and Mikhail Kraft of Germany won a very dramatic men's pairs competition. And those who've done their work and won their medals get to watch on and have some fun, as Niels Daniel, the master of ceremonies on the ground floor, has got the members of the crowd trying out some acrobatic style lifts. You will see some spectacular acrobatic lifts in this session because it's the men's group final, 4 gymnasts in each group.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner!
The Wrocław Games has also been the home of aerobic and rhythmic gymnastics, which took place right at the start of our gymnastics program earlier on in these games. The Avarina twins of the Russian Federation were dominant in the rhythmic events. Arena took gold in the ball, hoop and ribbon, and sister Dina won the clubs. Linoy Ashram of Israel, the silver medalist in the clubs, was the only gymnast to break that 1-2 monopoly of the incredibly impressive Avarinas. The aerobic competition, much more varied. The Russian Federation won the aerobic step, but there were medals for Spain, the Republic of Korea, the People's Republic of China and Japan. So the golds were much more distributed. Three of the events in this session are part of the trampolining program. Trampoline gymnastics has been part of the Olympics since Sydney in 2000. But there are some very different events in the World Games trampolining and tumbling program. In the Olympics, there's just an individual trampoline competition on the standard size trampoline. The World Games has the double mini trampoline for men and women individual, and then the men's and women's synchro competitions. And added to that is the tumbling for men and women. So we have plenty of gymnastics coming up in this session. The gymnasts are being introduced for the double mini trampoline final, the women's double mini trampoline event that had qualification earlier in the session, earlier in the day. And here come the athletes that will be participating in that. They're going to go in reverse order of qualification scores. So the highest qualifier, Bronwyn Dibb of New Zealand, will be last to go. As is always customary, we'll have the gymnasts introduced at the start of a trampoline or tumbling event, and then they'll have a touch warm-up, just some brief contact time. There is Inês Martins of Portugal. Mariana Aquino of Brazil. Tamara O'Brien of Canada. Kirsty Way of Great Britain. Very enthusiastic reception from the crowd. Lena Sjöberg from Sweden.
United States, Paige Howard.
Paige Howard of the United States of America. Bianca Zunekind of the Republic of South Africa. And the highest qualifier, Bronwyn Dibb of New Zealand. The gymnasts now have their touch warm-up, a little contact time with the apparatus, and that will give us chance to look at the apparatus and to see exactly what they have got to do. The double mini trampoline, each gymnast will have two passes at the apparatus. If you're new to trampoline tumbling disciplines, a pass is what might in other forms of gymnastics be known as a routine. And they have to go, as you can see, from the sloping bed to the flat bed. And then aim to land in that red area. So the gymnast will perform two skills. The final skill is the dismount skill that sends them onto that landing mat. And we've got a very enthusiastic crowd in attendance today. And that brings with it excitement for the gymnast. It also brings with it a little pressure too. I think they might have seen themselves on the big screen there, you know. We're looking at Mariana Aquino of Brazil. And if a gymnast lands plumb in the red there, then there's no deduction on their landing. But those areas outside are ones to watch for. If the gymnast lands in the yellow, then they get a 0.3 deduction automatically. And should they land in the blue, that's a 0.5 deduction straight away. There can be additions to this, such as if the gymnast steps from one area into another, they get a 0.1 deduction. So it's the original deduction plus a 0.1. So for example, if you land in the red and step back into the yellow, sort of as we had there really, that would be 0.1 deduction. If you land in the yellow and step back into the blue, it would be 0.3 plus the 0.1, so a 0.4 deduction. There can be additional deductions made for gymnasts taking too many steps on landing, not having the arms stable when they land, not landing upright, landing in a piked position. Sounds, doesn't it, like there's so much the judges might be taking marks off for. And to a certain extent, that's true. That's the nature of the execution marking, based on a deduction system. Lovely landing right in the red there. But also, the gymnasts are being credited for difficulty as well. So the more they can put into the two skills, the more they will earn from the difficulty judges. Those on the D panel. So we're back to the start again, to Inês Martins. We go round once more for another warm-up. And that will be also the format of the final itself. Every gymnast has a first pass, and then they have a second go. And the total score is what determines the medal. So we'll start to have a good idea about things after the first run, where each gymnast goes once. It's only really at that halfway point that you can start to get a concrete feel of who's in the chase, who's out of it. You can see the mat there that the coaches use, the spotters. And obviously they may elect to put that in if the gymnasts don't seem to have got their angle of approach right, if they're having some difficulties at all to prevent injury. But obviously the moment the coach becomes involved and has to put the mat in, then it's very hefty deductions. Gymnasts have got to land a skill in order to be credited for it. So they've got to actually land on their feet in order to be the beneficiaries of the judges' scores. And the way the judges will find it difficult to deduct for execution, find very little to take off, is if the gymnast can really keep their knees tucked in when they're doing a tuck, if they can keep their thighs close to their body in the piked position, and if their body is really straight at the point when it must be straight. So when the gymnast kicks out at the top of a skill element, is the body position good there? Are the toes pointed? Are the legs together? We're going to find out all of this and how the scores are going to look, because it's time to get underway in the women's double mini trampoline final here at the World Games of 2017. And we will start with the Portuguese gymnast Inês Martins. She was the eighth highest qualifier with 62.7, a 32.9 and a 29.8 were her scores. Inês Martins then, the first to go in this double mini trampoline final for women in the World Games of 2017. That carries with it the pressure as she steadies herself with a little breath. And another one. Can Martins get off to a good start here? Very secure indeed. Nothing really unsettling for her there. Nothing wrong with that at all. It was a nice, secure start. Good angle. Landing nice and square in the red. There'll be some deductions for the imprecision of form as she landed on the flatbed or went into her approach on the flatbed. You can see that the legs move out there. They don't stay very together. But it's very secure work, and it carries with it a score of 33.9 for Inês Martins. And the more gymnasts that go through clean in this final, the more it starts to put pressure on those to come. Look of great intensity on the face of Mariana Aquino of Brazil. Powerful run-up. She just overshot a little bit there. Not quite able to control the power in that run-up, and she knows it. Looks really disappointed. Carries a hefty deduction landing automatically onto the blue, a 0.5 deduction. Powerful approach. And just springs a little bit too far off the far end of the flatbed. Nice form in the pike position, straight legs, but height sacrificed for distance there, and that always leads to deductions. You can see that she was quite close to the edge of the flatbed. So awaiting the score of Mariana Aquino of Brazil. An event that Brazil have had some success in at the World Games. The men's competition was won by Bruno Martini in 2013. 33.2 for Aquino puts her in second place. She's 0.7 behind Martins. Tamara O'Brien of Canada won a team gold in this event at the World Championships in 2015. Canada have some terrific trampoline gymnasts. What a lovely landing that was. Steady. She looked like she thought that was okay. Breathe a big sigh of relief now. The first pass is done. nice position on the flatbed. Kept the line pretty straight there. Not much movement to one side. Toes pointed. Legs very much together there. So you'd expect this to have a really positive evaluation from the judges. It's a 35.7 for Tamara O'Brien, puts her quite handsomely in the lead. Kirsty Way of Great Britain was the fifth highest qualifier on a 67.3. Just a big step forward as she landed. Didn't quite have a huge amount of height, the second skill, but a lot that went well.
First class on the little mini trampoline. This is
approach here, not too bad. A little bit of untidiness in her body position. Slow motions are always unkind on that sort of thing. They highlight the separation of the legs and the lack of straightness where there needs to be straightness. So the execution score will have some deductions in there, but some decent difficulty. 7.2 difficulty score for Way. It's a 33.9. Her execution the lowest so far, 26.7. But she's well positioned. We have a joint second place at the moment. Lena Sjöberg of Sweden was the fourth highest qualifier. She's got a great deal of height with the first skill, just lost her line on the second, moving across and landing in the yellow for a 0.3 deduction, but there was still plenty in that routine that the judges can award from a difficulty standpoint. You can see there when the gymnast hits the flatbed at an awkward angle, then it can cause them to really spring off in the wrong direction. And she was very close to catching the mats at the side of the apparatus. And that caused that slightly sideways bounce. 35.3 for Sjöberg. The difficulty is the key there, 8.4. There was indeed a lot for the judges to credit. Paige Howard of the United States of America. So currently it's O'Brien 1, Sjöberg 2, and Martins 3, and Way also joint third. Precise. She looks pretty happy about that one. There's Paige Howard. She qualified in third position with a 67.9. This is some good work. Straight line. No uncertainty in the feet positioning as she lands. Straightness of legs and pointed toes. And quite a smile as well. Will she be smiling after the second pass? It's a 35.1 for Howard. High execution, the highest execution so far. Just didn't have as much difficulty as others. Bianca Zunikind of the Republic of South Africa took part in the tumbling final yesterday, finished seventh there. She was a much higher qualifier in this apparatus. 68.9 was her qualifying score, and that looks strong. Cutting a different sort of figure in this competition, looks much more at ease. Yes, the deductions will be there. She transitions out of the pike in the first skill. The legs just start to wobble and come apart a little. But there's some good difficulty in that pass. 8.4 is the highest difficulty we've had so far. to Lena Sjöberg. Sjöberg sits in second place. 35.2 for Zunekind, a difficulty score of 8 there, really important. The second highest E score we've had, so puts her in third. Highest qualifier, last to go in the first pass, Bronwyn Dibb of New Zealand. And she has started well indeed. Just the smallest of movements on landing, but we have got ourselves a real final here. A lot of contenders for medals. Dibb was eighth in the World Championship final in this discipline in 2015. We'll be hoping and looking and likely to achieve a significantly higher finish here. It's a 34.5 for Bronwyn Dibb. And that puts her in fifth place at the end of the first pass. So let's have a look at it. It's O'Brien in gold at the moment, Sjöberg in silver, and Zunekind in bronze. Paige Howard very close though, just 0.1 behind in fourth. Then there's a little bit of daylight. It's the second pass, Inez Martins. 33.9 had her in sixth place at the end of the first pass. This is now where we're going to start to get a sense of who's where. The pressure increases as the gymnasts go for big skills as they look to have a high difficulty score and match it with the execution. Very often in these second passes, there's the potential for something untoward to happen, for someone to not get their rotation right on landing, but Martins did exactly what she needed to do here and just be secure. The more that go through clean, the more the pressure is on those still to go. 33.8 and a 33.9, 67.7 for Martin. She's been very solid, very consistent. And Martin's is in first place, but that's because she's the only one that's completed a second pass. Mariana Aquino always has a look of real focus on her face as she approaches the apparatus. And that was good. That's her work done. She was positioned in last place at the end of the first pass. And is certainly feeling the emotion of the occasion, unsurprisingly. Second skill, much stronger this time round. She got her height and distance better. The legs did not look so tidy after the first skill. Just see there, they're a little bit all over the place, but they were not all over the place in the landing. They were very sharp. It means a lot to these gymnasts. 35.1, what a big improvement for Aquino. She has 68.3 and moves into the lead. Tamara O'Brien of Canada. 35.7 was the best score of the first pass. And she's certainly keeping the pressure on. She's really keeping the pressure on here, O'Brien, who was the sixth highest qualifier. Canada took a silver in this event in Cali and a gold in Duisburg in 2005. Here's Tamara O'Brien on her way to a podium place. Good form in the pike position. Keeps the toes nicely pointed as she approaches the landing. What's it going to be? 35.3, an even 71. Puts her in first place. Kirsty Way of Great Britain, 33.9, had her in sixth place after the first pass. Just a small step back, but she brought that back under control well, and then smiles and relaxes. At the moment we have O'Brien, 71. Aquino, 68.3. Martins, 67.7. That's the leaderboard as it stands with the second passes complete. Where does Kirsty Wave fit into that equation?
First place for Tamara O'Brien now.
68.7 for Kirsty Way moves her into the silver medal position. Aquino drops down into bronze, and we have four to go. Lina Sjöberg of Sweden was in second place with a 35.3 after the first. And she's put the difficulty into that routine. She had the highest D score, 8.4. That was all important. Now, Tamara O'Brien's second part had a difficulty score of 7.2. So is there an opportunity for Sjöberg to move up here? Is there a chance for her to sneak the lead? I think there's quite a lot to credit. It's 70 for Sjöberg. She's in the silver medal position. She was not far off at all, just a point between them, but O'Brien of Canada still hangs on. What about the challenge from Paige Howard? 35.1 after the first routine in fourth place. Another extremely precise landing from Paige Howard. The standard here is terrific. Talk about handling the expectation and handling the pressure. This is a delight. And it's going to create a really intriguing finish to things, because all of this, all of these strong, clean passes at the double mini trampoline just keep pointing the attention at those left to go, at the two left to go. O'Brien leads on 71, Sjöberg second on 70, Way 68.7. Not now. Paige Howard has gone into the gold medal position, 71.4. A 36.3 for her second pass. It's the highest individual score. Any pass of this final. Janka Zunekind was in the bronze position after the first pass. She did come in as the second highest qualifier. She's really gone for it and manages to stabilize her landing. This is going to be very, very tight. Certainly working that difficulty score. Trying to give the judges a lot to credit. She had a difficulty score of 8 in the first pass. Just a little hop forwards as she lands, but all of these tiny things could be costly. It's 69 for Zunakin. She's in fourth place, has just missed out on a medal there. Last to go is Bronwyn Dibb. Paige Howard and Tamara O'Brien in one and two are sure of medals. But what medals? Couldn't have stuck that landing more authoritatively. Bronwyn Dibb of New Zealand had 34.5 in her first pass. It's been the most remarkable incident of people handling the occasion. Such good management of the pressure. Paige Howard in gold, Tamara O'Brien in silver, Lena Sjöberg in bronze. It's 70 plus that's needed for Dibb to secure a medal. And Dibb has just missed out there. She's 69.7, puts her in fourth place. Just by 0.3, she misses out on a medal. And that means it's gold for Paige Howard of the United States of America. It's silver for Tamara O'Brien of Canada. And bronze for Lena Sjöberg of Sweden. That was a wonderful final. She looked so happy after both of her passes, did Paige Howard. She's going to look even happier in a moment, receiving a gold medal. Gold for the USA, silver for Canada, bronze for Sweden. Well, I think you can safely say we've got underway, haven't we, here in the Centennial Hall? That sets the standard for a great session of gymnastics finals. And I think all of the gymnasts there, whether they did or didn't medal, can know they gave it their all. You can't ask for more than those gymnasts gave. Sjöberg of Sweden, the bronze medalist. We look at her two passes. And this, the work of Tamara O'Brien, getting a silver and carrying on Canada's strong history in this discipline at the World Games. And Paige Howard of the United States of America, the gold medalist. She was a team bronze medalist for the United States of America in the World Championships of 2015, and now an individual gold at the World Games. And it is the first gold for the USA in this discipline at the World Games. This was an event won by Russia in 2009 and 2013, but this only the second final that has not featured a Russian gymnast. The aerobic mixed pair was the one before that on the first day of competition. So it was certainly an opportunity for everyone else to get in amongst the medals. And it was the USA and it was Paige Howard who took the advantage most decisively, or took the opportunity most decisively. We're going to enjoy the victory ceremony in a moment for this previous final, the women's double mini trampoline, and then move on to the acrobatic gymnastics program and the last event there, the men's group final. And after that, it'll be back to trampolining for the men's tumbling final and the women's synchro trampoline. So a lot of drama still to come here at the Centennial Hall. And the victory ceremonies take place after each event. The gymnasts don't have much turnaround time. That's why there's a short delay here. And of course, that podium's got to be put in position. And then the screen behind it taken away again so that everyone has the best view possible. And it's not difficult to have the best view in a space like this. Lovely open space. The high dome of the ceiling enabling the construction of a building with uninterrupted sight lines for all spectators. And it is a very historic building as well, the Centennial Hall from 1913. Lots has been happening around the Centennial Hall as well. The grounds have been used for things like boule and for archery. What a program of sports here at these World Games that first began, of course, back in Santa Clara in 1981. And the USA will move on to Birmingham, Alabama in 2021 as the defending champions in this event. Time for the victory ceremony for the women's double mini trampoline competition at the World Games of 2017 in Wrocław, Poland. These games first took place in Santa Clara in California in 1981, and it's a Californian that has won the gold medal in the form of Paige Howard of the United States of America. And it's a joyous victory ceremony, this, because it's first medals for lots of nations here in this gymnastics program. It's a first gold for the US, first medals for Sweden and Canada. The 23-year-old Lena Sjöberg of Sweden is the bronze medalist. High difficulty in her first pass of 8.4, helping her on the way to a score of 70 and helping Sweden on the way to their first medal of this gymnastics program at the World Games. Bronze for Lena Sjöberg. Tamara O'Brien adds her name to the list of successful Canadians in this event. Sarah Childs won gold in 05, Carissa Boychuk the silver in 2013, and now Tamara O'Brien with a silver medal of her very own. Her list of honours grows in the sport of trampolining.
Ladies and gentlemen, they will
The US have won a bronze in this discipline and a silver in 05 and 09 respectively, but this is the first time that the USA has taken gold in the women's double mini trampoline at the World Games. Paige Howard has done it. She is the gold medalist in the 2017 edition of the World Games here in Poland. A a score of 71.4, helping her on the way to top spot on the podium. And we'll now hear the national anthem of the United States of America. Round of applause for the medalists in the women's double mini trampoline final here at the World Games of 2017. Bronze for Lina Sjöberg of Sweden, silver Tamara O'Brien of Canada, and the gold for Paige Howard of the USA.